As the road to VixenMania gets ever closer and closer to its destination, we come to you with This Week in VWF Monday Nitro. We're going to start off in a big way with a Queen of the Mountain qualifier match. Here's one of the two ladies who'll be taking part, Hillary Duff, making her way to the ring. She'll be competing tonight against Lara Croft, but a far more serious situation unfolding because it has been 2 weeks and we still have not seen any signs of Tifa Lockhart following the actions in which it appeared she was choke slammed to hell. Ladies and gentlemen, we are still in a state of shock over that particular event. Of course, we're going to keep you posted on any details that we can find out. Focus now on this matchup here. Here's one of the two competitors in it, Miss Hillary Duff. And she is going to be stepping into the ring to face off against the pride of Sheffield, England, the one and only Lara Croft, the Tomb Raider. And let's go ahead and see her right now. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen, the Tomb Raider herself, Lara Croft. And this promises to be one matchup, ladies and gentlemen. One of these two ladies will be going to VixenMania coming up in just 2 weeks to compete in that amazing Queen of the Mountain ladder match, winner of which will get a guaranteed World Heavyweight title match anytime between VixenMania and next year's VixenMania. It's our tremendous stakes. The bell has rung. We are underway. And this promises to be a good even matchup. Collar and elbow tie-up. Side headlock there by Hillary. And reversed out into a headlock by Lara. Fans, also on tonight's card, we have planned for you another Queen of the Mountain qualifier match. It is going to be Rey Hino taking on Riku. We've also got in tag team action the Simpson Sisters, Ashley and Jessica, taking on Team G4, Olivia Munn and Morgan Webb. And in your TV main event, oh, what a contest this plans to be. It's going to be the villainous, destructive, almost demonic Astarte taking on Ami Mizuno. So, folks, you picked a great evening to be joining us here on YouTube for VWF Monday Nitro, and wherever you might be, we're so glad you're joining us here as opening bout gets underway here. Crossbody there by Lara Croft. And, oh, a kick to the back there. Lara Croft, far more of the, what you might say, a rough and tumble sort of competitor. She has shown on more than one occasion she is, oh, more than willing to mix it up. I guess if you're an archaeologist, you almost have to be. Hook of the leg now for that great DDT. Only gets a one count, though, as this match is underway. Irish whip into the corner, and now Hillary, no, reversed into an Uranagi by Lara. Early going of this match, Lara Croft, the aggressor. And that is what you want to see in the early going. You want to see someone establishing dominance, because that will pay off dividends, in my opinion. Like right there with that great tilt-a-whirl DDT by Lara Croft. Fans, if I do sound a bit nasal, I do apologize for that. I've been battling some allergies over the last few days. Hopefully you'll understand. But that couldn't keep me away. And oh, Lara Croft not kept away with that nice cross body off the ropes. Hook of the leg now into a cover, gets a one count, and nothing more. Early going of this match, very exciting, very hot and heavy as we are on the road to VixenMania. I've said it before, folks, tickets in Glendale, Arizona, University of Phoenix Stadium are already sold out, so you can't join us in person. What you can do is join us live exclusively on pay-per-view. Make sure you contact your local cable operator, your satellite provider. Find out how you can join us on pay-per-view. There's also going to be ways to join us via internet pay-per-view. Check out with your local ISP on that one as they get into this contest. And Hillary went for a crossbody of her own, but it was blocked by Lara Croft. In the early going of a contest such as this, Lara Croft now, punch to the forehead. And, oh, a nice takedown there by Hillary Duff into a bulldog. And now, Hillary becoming a bit of the aggressor. Sort of back and forth here in the early going. And now Hillary has got Lara up. Oh, and a powerbomb. Shades of the great Sid Vicious with that maneuver. Lateral press cover only gets a one count there. Reverse neckbreaker, and now Hillary up to the top rope. Oh, and a nice elbow, but it did not connect. And she tasted the canvas. Now Lara up. Oh, and that cross body springboard into a nice splash and a tilt-a-whirl leg drop. Tell you, fans, Lara Croft really impressing me in this early going of this matchup. We're near the 5-minute mark of this opening bout. A lot at stake. The winner going to VixenMania for the Queen of the Mountain ladder match. So much on the line. Oh, because Usagi Tsukino earlier this year showed what happens when you have that briefcase. She cashed it in, became world champion. Inside cradle now. Cover one, and no. And elbows there, and now Lara Croft. Over the top rope goes Hillary. She will hold on to the rope. Oh, but is knocked off the apron to the concrete floor by Lara. And now Lara waiting. She's got something in mind, it would appear. She starts getting some energy from the fans. She's up. Oh, and a plancha. But there was no one home. Hillary able to scout the maneuver. And now she uppers up. Oh, and a plancha of her own. And that one will connect. Hillary Duff now has Lara up, throws her back into the ring. And Lara now changing some verbiage with Hillary. And, well, a rope-assisted dropkick, that'll settle any debate. And all the way over, hits her own plancha. But if you'll notice, didn't get all of it because she didn't quite get the connection I think she wanted. And she tasted the floor just as long as did Hillary, but Hillary knocked to the ground and she's out. Back in the ring now we go. And now, Lara reversal by Hillary Duff. Reversal by Lara. Side headlock. And puts the boot in. Oh, a kick and down goes Hillary Duff. Now a quick cover. Lateral press. One, two, no. Two count only and a bulldog headlock there by Lara Croft. Folks, the buzz for VixenMania getting so huge. Oh, a Sai moonsault into a splash there. And then into a nice tilt-a-whirl leg drop. Lara's got Hillary up now. Oh, and a backstabber neckbreaker. That'll settle any sort of a debate right there. Hillary, nope, has got Lara trying to reverse her position. Lara, oh, wait a minute, this could be the Tomb Raider. Oh, and that's it. That package pile driver, but no. Hillary up. How she's up, I have no idea. And now she's got Lara up. Oh, wait, this could be it. Oh, Boston Crab. She's going for a Boston Crab. Walls of Jericho style. It has it locked in. And she's cranking back on that lower spine, trying to get her to submit. Will she do it? Yes, she will. She will get the submission. And this match is over. 7 minutes, 43 seconds is your time. And it is all she wrote. Amazing win there. And Hillary Duff is going to join her other opponents now in the Queen of the Mountain match at VixenMania. What a win. Impressive victory by Hillary Duff. And folks, we're going to go to the back right now where our camera is there because we're being told. Yep, there it is. Let's take a look back there now. Ladies and gentlemen, when those two women are planning and plotting like that, I can tell you right now, it can't possibly be any good.
But folks, we're going to move on right now to our next contest. Tag team action. And here come the Simpson sisters, Ashley and Jessica, making their way to the ring. These ladies have not been having the sort of luck that they've been having in recent weeks. They've been not doing very well in the one-loss department. And some people in the back saying that there's been some dissension in the ranks between these two. So we're hoping, obviously, that the two of them can get back on their winning ways tonight. They have a task ahead of them as they're facing off against Team G4. And here they come right now, Olivia Munn and Morgan Webb. Both of these teams, I'm sure, would love a chance to become tag team champions of the world. A victory here will definitely move you up the ranks in the tag team division of the Vixens Wrestling Federation. But I've said on more than one occasion, you have to get it done in the ring. You can talk all you want to, but you've got to be able to get it done as competitors. That is the challenge facing these two groups of ladies today. Should be exciting as we get this matchup underway. Bell sounds, we're underway. Ashley and Morgan Webb start off this particular contest. And back to the point I was making earlier. You know, I said it before, tag teams are always tested by those times, like any athlete, when you enter a slump. When, you know, what you're doing just ain't working for you, and whatever you're trying to do is just not being victorious for you. And as a result, it does test your mettle. And especially with a tag team where you have two individuals, that can be pretty difficult. So I think we're seeing how they can handle being tested. Because more than a few people behind the scenes say that their relationship is a bit more frosty than it usually has been. But you know what? A big victory over a great tag team like Team G4 could be just the tonic they need, but they'll have to do better than that, as Morgan Webb now with a neck breaker into a pinfall maneuver, but doesn't get a one count there. Ashley and Jessica Simpson, both from the Lone Star State. Their sisters know each other inside and out, and that is important in tag team wrestling. Ashley up now, perched on the top turnbuckle, waiting. Oh, look at that! Went for a cross body, but Morgan wasn't able to block it. Ashley now back, club to the back there. They say tag team wrestling, Dusty Rhodes always called it the game of human chess. Deep arm drag there by Ashley Simpson now. They say you always want to draw that line right down the middle of the ring, and you want to keep your opponents on your side of that line. And we're seeing that right now. Oh, and a bulldog from Ashley. And another bulldog from Ashley. I tell you, she's a house of fire now. Maybe she's woken up. Third bulldog headlock. But now, Olivia Munn has a hold of her, trying to stop her progress, and she will. Ashley now squirms loose, trying to protect her partner there. Oh, and a jawbreaker from Morgan Webb. That may have just been the tonic she needed. And you'd have to think that the World Tag Team Champions, Haruka and Michiru, are watching this contest with great import. Because you never know, in the future, they might have to face either of these teams in the coming weeks. As Olivia Munn tagged in now, the back suit play there. And, oh, a drop kick right to the forehead. And now an arm bar there. Hey, all four of these ladies are phenomenal in-ring competitors. Kick away there from Ashley. She might want to think about making a tag. Oh, and a lariat right there. And, well, there you go. Tags in Jessica Simpson. The hallmark of any good tag team are those quick tags, keeping the fresh wrestlers in the ring for as quickly as possible. That is the key to any good wrestling tag team. And these Simpson Sisters are obviously very good at that, as a front dropkick takes down Olivia Munn. Oh, and a spinning toe hold there. Shades of the great Dory Funk Jr. with that maneuver. Makes sense, they're both Texans. And now, Olivia under the ropes, in comes Ashley. Might see some double team maneuvers. Oh, and a punch right to the kidneys by Ashley Simpson. Bulldog again. You ask any professional fighter, they'll tell you kidney punches like that, they'll stop a fight like nothing. There's a reason why they are illegal in professional boxing, because it will take you to the mat like nothing before. Olivia now able to shake it off, and now she's working over Ashley in the corner. Oh, went for a double axe handle, but Ashley blocked it and answers back with a clothesline of her own. Goes to the top rope now. She's waiting for Olivia to get up. High risk maneuver. Oh, and a back elbow will take down Olivia Munn. And a little mind games there for good measure. Tell you, these Simpson sisters wrestling like the Simpsons of old, showing off some great in-ring ability and an X factor by Ashley Simpson. Now quick cover. Gets a one count, gets a two count, and that's all she's going to get. Morgan in, able to break up the pinning predicament. And this match will continue on. And scooping a full body slam by Ashley Simpson, folks. Well, Morgan's down. That might be the break that Ash is looking for, going to the top rope. And a senton from the top. But if I were her, I'd get out of that side of the ring. Gets a one count, and that's the reason why. Morgan Webb able to break up the pin with just the one count. And oh, head scissor takeover by Olivia Munn. Going to the top rope now. On a moonsault press. We're past the 5 minute mark in this encounter, and Olivia gonna go to her corner. Will she get the tag in? No, she won't. Was out of the ring there. Interesting situation. Now she'll make the tag. Maybe want to just regroup for about 2 seconds there. Elbow, and down goes Morgan Webb, the fresh wrestler in this contest. And she is now really working over Ashley Simpson, who would want to make a tag of her own. Kick. She's up. Oh, and a baseball slide drop kick right to the head of Ashley Simpson. She's got Ashley back up now. What is she thinking? Oh, got her by the leg. And, oh, and an ankle lock. Oh, and drives her knee right into the ring canvas. I said it before, folks. That ring canvas, so painful. So painful to get dropped onto. Morgan throws Ashley, and Ashley comes out. Another Irish whip into the corner. We're going to see a double team maneuver here, would appear. Wait a minute. Oh, a rocket launcher by Morgan Webb on with Olivia Munn onto Ashley Simpson. Excuse me, fans. I apologize for that. Oh, and a head scissor takeover. And down goes Ashley. But will she make the tag? Yes! Last ounce of strength gets the tag. Down will go Olivia. And down goes Morgan. No, she doesn't. Oh, did you see that? Morgan well scouted, able to lean back, and will drop her neck first onto the ring apron. Cover one, two, and no. Almost a three count, and it was a very, very long two count, but able to break it up. And now Jessica answers back with a drop kick. Putting those boots in. Jessica, the fresher competitor. Oh, an X factor of her own. These Simpson sisters can really make things happen in that ring, and that drop kick there, example of that. Look at the leg now. Gets a cover. One, no. Not even one count. Didn't have enough but for that pin. I'm not going to lie. I didn't see enough of that. Oh, and a drop kick will take down Olivia Munn. These Simpson sisters are doing very well. I mean, I'm going to give them credit. They're really working hard in that ring. On a quick tag in. In will come Ashley again. But she's favoring her head. She's obviously been hurt. And what is she going to be thinking? Oh, a kick to the midsection and another X Factor. Obviously loves that maneuver. Now hook of the leg of her own. Gets in the cover. One, two. Morgan again breaks up the pin. I'm going to tell you, fans, that is why tag team wrestling is so much harder to match than singles wrestling, because you got two people in there, and it is not easy at all. Hurricane Rana takeover by Olivia Munn, but now Ash is going to try for the tag, gets the tag, in comes Jessica, down goes Olivia, and now, will she get Morgan? No! Again, able to duck under. I thought she had her, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, and Wood went for a clothesline, but Ashley scouts the maneuver, and down goes Olivia Munn. Oh, and a huge plancha! And Jessica picks up the 7-10 split, you might say, and will take down Olivia Munn. Oh, and throws her into the ring steps. And now she's got her up. Oh, and throws her back into the ring. She's got her up. Will she try a maneuver here? Oh, went for a drop kick, but it was blocked. Shining Wizard, also blocked. Oh, a club to the back by Olivia. She's got her up. Oh, victory roll. Gets in a cover. One, two. No reversal into a sunset flip. Cover one, two. Reversal again. Cover one. Will this be enough? It is over! This match is over! Amazing victory! Team G4 picks up the win. 10 minutes, 24 seconds is your time. And here's a highlight of that nice rocket launcher. Shades of the Midnight Express there. And the frustration, I'm sure, continues to grow within the ranks of the Simpson Sisters. As Team G4 picks up a hard-fought victory. And there it is again, that reversal into a sunset flip gets in the cover. And it was all over. And, well, it would appear, well, we're going to have some words here, it would appear. Well, you had to see it coming, ladies and gentlemen. Obviously, some dissension within the ranks of the Simpson Sisters. And it's all just boiled over to this situation right now. Well, folks, you hate to see a tag team like this die out, but we're going to see a great matchup. Fix this thing. Oh, we're back on. Sorry. So much happening in so little time, folks. We're going to try to move on from that. It's going to be our main event, but coming up right now, we've got Rey Hino versus Riku for the fifth spot in the Queen of the Mountain Ladder match coming up at VixenMania. Folks, this should be good. Speaking of Rey Hino, here she comes right now. Rey Hino appears to have recovered from her injury she sustained at Judgment Day. And what a feather in her cap would it be to have been in the finals of the Intergalactic Championship Tournament, which she gave up. Let's not lie to ourselves there. She gave up that position to now win Queen of the Mountain. And here's the stepping stone how to get there, to be in the match to become Queen of the Mountain, but you'll have to win this one to do it. And you'll have to go through the lady we're about to meet. Here she comes. It is the lady known as Riku. Here she comes right now. She and Yuna, who had a great deal of history together. Yuna, who lost the finals of the Intergalactic Championship Tournament, so she might want to try to avenge that defeat. How would she go about doing it? Well, she'd go about doing it by getting into Queen of the Mountain. Makes her way to the ring. Very popular lady, this individual. She loves those fans, and they love her right back. She makes her way into the ring. I'll tell you, folks, this is going to be an encounter that we ain't never seen before. A lot at stake, so folks, hope you're excited. We get this one underway. folks, you're going to see one of these two ladies at VixenMania. I cannot stress enough just how big this show is going to be. Please get your cable or satellite provider on the horn. Pre-order this event on pay-per-view. You do not want to miss it as we start this contest now. Opening feeling out process from both ladies. And there you go, collar and elbow tie-up. And side headlock there by Ray Hino. Into a waist lock. Nope, headlock there by Ray. And into a waist lock by Riku. Nope, back elbow. Lots of moves and counter moves nearly going to this contest. And you almost want to see that in a matchup like this. So much on the line, you want both ladies to be on their A game. And we're seeing it right now. Oh, up and... Whoa, look at that! Nice, almost like a triple jump arm drag. Quick cover and very quick kick out there. And Riku comes out, leapfrog by Ray. Oh, and a Luthez press and start putting the fists in. Simple yet effective, like that kick to the back. And she is controlling the pace in the early going of this matchup. A back elbow there. Oh, and quick, look at that. Now the elbows to the shoulder blades there. I'd never seen that before. Had her in a sleeper hold position, then just dropped her. That is a painful maneuver. Would have to be, oh, and a gut buster. Definitely painful. That'll take your breath away. Hook of the leg now, cover, and no. Riku has a lot to prove, as does Ray Hino, that they both deserve to be in the main event. One of the main events, you might say, of VixenMania coming up on pay-per-view as Ray Hino starts taking control of this matchup. Some Savate kicks. Oh, and a front drop kick. Now she's got Riku up. Irish whip into the corner. No, Riku up. Oh, and goes for a sort of a back handspring into a cross body, but it just didn't work. This is an amazing contest in the early, early going. So in a quick arm drag takeover. And again, those elbows to the shoulder blades, that's going to affect your neck as well because those muscles all interconnected. Hook of the leg by Riku. Cover one. No. Not all she's going to get on that maneuver. Now those elbows. Hits her away. Oh, and look at this. Hurricanrana by Ray Hino. He's got Riku back up now. Kick to the gut. Oh, and there it is. Could it be the rolling mandala? No, but a very impressive move. Cover one. Well, sort of a rolling mandala pin predicament there. Only gets a one count, though. Really, for that sort of a maneuver, I would have to think. Ray into the ropes now. She comes out. Riku in for a drop kick, but Ray blocked it. And a spinning wheel kick does hit the mark. Pushed away by Riku. Very evenly matched, this contest proving to be, as we get into the early part of it, you might say. And now Riku against that top rope. Oh, and an arm bar. Sort of a Sullivan bar maneuver. Sort of a reverse key using the top rope for leverage. And well, look at that. Top rope moonsault press does not hit the mark. And now Riku trying to take advantage. Lateral press. It's a one count and no more. And Riku up. Oh, and a back handspring off the top rope into a back elbow, which finds the mark. And she has got her on Dream Street right now. Cover one now. Two. No. Not all you're going to get there in the two count because Ray still got a lot of fight left in her. Oh, and went for the top rope, but did not hit it. Now, Asai moonsault, but does not hit the mark because we're out of the ring. And Riku takes advantage, slamming her knee right into the floor of the VWF arena. And now they're at the security railing. She's got Ray up. Ray! Oh! Was going to drop her onto the top railing, but Ray able to get loose, and now she's going to take advantage. Up on the ring apron now. Oh, but she hesitated, and she who hesitated lost. And, oh, a nice bulldog there from Riku as the count reaches its midpoint. And she'll throw Ray back into the ring, and is she going to, yes, elbow right to the side of the head. And Riku on the ring apron. Now she's up. Oh, look at that! Leg lariat takedown. Now cover, but that's about all. Then you get a one count there. Oh, and a float over DDT by Riku. I tell you, fans, it's Riku, a phenomenal competitor. And she's feeling it. She could be going for the Al Bed drop. But nope. A Hurricane Rana into a pin cradle. Cover one. No reversal into a sunset flip. Cover one. Two. No. Ray able to get loose. Wait a minute. It could be this. Is it the Al Bed driver? She's got her up. And yes! Hits the Al Bed drop. That kill switch maneuver. But no. She sets her up. Oh, and that's it! She has hit the Rolling Mandala! Hits the cover now. One, two, no. Now she's up. Oh, and a bulldog. She's thinking of something up to the top rope now. She's up. Nice moonsault. Gets a nice arc on it. And she's thinking of nothing good right now. She puts the boot in on a kick to the face right there. She's up. Oh, and a big splash by Ray Hino. Ray Hino now has got Riku. She's got her. Oh, she could be thinking. 6-1-9! And dial up. West Coast pop. Cover one. Gets a two count and no. Only gets a two count there. Oh, back elbow. And oh, a nice bulldog there. And now going to the top rope. Will she hit a higher risk maneuver? She's thinking of something. Another moonsault. And that one found the mark. She's already hit one Rolling Mandala. Will she hit another? Yes, she will! And that's going to have to put her away. Second Rolling Mandala, cover one. Is it going to be over now? No. Whoa! Riku able to kick out of two Rolling Mandalas. I am impressed with her resilience in this matchup. Oh, there it is. Victory roll. Could this be it? One, two, will she get out? No, she doesn't. It's over. Amazing win by Riku. 8 minutes, 11 seconds, your time. Riku able to withstand two Rolling Mandalas. And she will come through to win. And now she is our fifth competitor in the Queen of the Mountain Ladder match at VixenMania. And if we can see that at VixenMania, could you be looking at your next Queen of the Mountain? I do think you just might be. What an amazing win. Oh, let's go to the back. what an event VixenMania is shaping up to be. But folks, it is time for our TV main event. The demonic Astarte takes on Ami Mizuno. What should be a very brutal encounter, folks. Without wasting any more time, let's take this to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, I have said this several occasions. How in the world do you stop Astarte? I've been around the business of wrestling for a long, long time. I have not seen a competitor, male or female, that cuts a figure quite like this individual. She is, well, the word demonic comes to mind when you consider who her master is, who she is apprenticing. The most vile human being, if you can even call her that, in professional wrestling today, Abdala bin Laden. She makes her way slowly, very deliberately to the ring. And a palpable sense of dread, fear, almost a sense of just impending doom fills the hearts of all 21,000 fans here at the VWF Arena. Ladies and gentlemen, I admire Ami Mizuno's courage, I admire her will, I admire her bravery. I've said this before, I question her sanity. Unless I was sentenced by a judge, I would not want to step into the ring with this woman. Because she is simply awe-inspiring, not in a good way. And now here comes her opponent, the one and only Ami Mizuno. You know, I'm going to say it. I, like you, have been shocked by this Al action because, you see right there, she won the Rumble Roses Battle Royal, and so she'll be facing Abdala bin Laden or whoever the World Heavyweight Champion is at VixenMania. She claims that she's just 100% again, but now, according to Abdala, part of her sailor powers, as she calls them, were stolen to help her, in her words, create Astarte. That had to have been an unholy ceremony, if indeed that is what happened. Like most of you, I wouldn't trust Abdala bin Laden as far as I could throw her. But just never know around this place, folks. You just never know. Ami has had so many problems with Abdala and all of Al-Qaeda lately. You wonder if it's finally gotten to her and she's lost her mind agreeing to this matchup. But we will find out, as always, when the bell rings. All we can do. It is time for this match to start. It is our TV main event. It is Ami versus Astarte. Bell sounds run away. Quick collar and elbow tie-up. This is going to be physical early, folks. I can just feel it. As Astarte now, reversal by Ami. Ami into a hammer lock and throws her away. But Astarte quick with a side headlock. Nope, knee by Ami. It's going to have to be Ami's mentality. It's going to have to be her strategy. That backstabber notwithstanding, hit high impact moves early. Try to get this over in a hurry. Oh, a choke slam reversed by Ami Mizuno. Don't take anything away from Ami. She's a phenomenal competitor. Oh, clothesline attempt, reversal. And one thing about an extremely tall person like Astarte, people who are extremely tall athletes, as she rams Ami's head into that ring canvas, they are clumsy, so she'll have to use that lack of coordination, if there is any. Side Russian leg sweep. Use that improved agility to her advantage. Wait a minute, she's got her up. Oh, double underhook into a power bomb. I mean, give Ami credit. She is a phenomenal wrestler, but we've seen the last few weeks, Astarte is just destructive. But points the elbow right to the forehead and nails it. As Astarte up, throws her into the rope. She comes out. Ducks under. Oh, a big back body drop, and down goes Astarte. Astarte now imposing her will, as they say in the sport of boxing. She's got her up. Oh, and a quick scoop body slam. Shades of the Dynamite Kid, who had those quick body slams. Oh, and would you look at that? We've seen that before. Using those ropes almost like a springboard, just to throw her back and deliver more punishment. Now puts those fists right into the side of the head. That'll concuss you like nothing. I mean, this Astarte is just viciousness personified. As Ami and as many others have found out, but Ami, Russian leg sweep, now into a pin, and only gets a one count. Irish whip now. Astarte. Oh, and a clothesline, and down goes Ami Mizuno. Ami now up. Irish whip into the corner. She comes out. Oh, and a short arm clothesline. Astarte starting to get momentum. And once this woman gets going, she's like a diesel engine. It might take her a minute to get started, but once she starts, she'll go for a long time, as that spine buster will show you. Lateral press, cover one, and that's about all she's going to get. Ami got fight in her. Give her that. She's got some fight left in her. But this Astarte, I have never seen anything like her. Oh, and a clothesline of her own, though. Ami starting to make a comeback here, it would appear. And what would it mean to her to be able to take this woman out this close to VixenMania? Would mean a lot for her match against Abdala, as she rams her neck right into that bottom ring rope. Speaking of Abdala, she's got to be watching this match with great importance. Ami a little slow to recover, and Astarte recovered quicker and was able to take advantage of that Polish hammer. And now she's the one who's got Ami and throws her all the way over the top rope. Right in front of our announce table, folks. I'm going to get up. Oh, and right into our announce table. Oh, it's right in front of us, folks. Slams her right to the mat, folks. I'm standing up. I got my microphone. And they seem to be moving away. Okay, I'm going to sit back down now. As Astarte has Ami up and drops her face first onto the security railing. You do not want to go blow for blow with this woman. She will take you down every time. She is just a creature of pure, unfiltered malevolence. Owen ducks under a Savate kick now, but Ami's got her in a side headlock. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, vertical suplex. And down goes Astarte. Now cover. But doesn't even get a one count. She is taking everything Ami's throwing at her and just dishing it right back. Another big back body drop. And now Astarte out. And another Luthez press. Could be Ami's got that second win going. And now she's got Astarte back up. Oh, double underhook. Could she be thinking that double underhook powerbomb? Yes, she is. And tells her exactly what she thinks of her. Maybe she's number 11 in her eyes. I don't know. I think we know what she meant, though. Yeah, you know what she meant. And she's letting Astarte know what she means, and she's ramming that boot. She's stomping a mud hole in that woman. And again, with that gesture, we can show that on YouTube, right, guys? Yeah, I thought we could. Okay. All right, hook of the leg now covers one, and no. Astarte into the rope. Now she comes out. Oh, a third back body drop. Ami Mizuno trying to end this match early, but she's fatigued. And she's up. Could she be thinking? Big elbow! Shades of the late, great Randy Macho Man Savage now covers her one count, and Astarte will kick out. Ami wants to win this match. She's going to have to get control. She's got it right now, but she's going to have to keep it. Find a way to keep control. Stay away from this woman. I know in a wrestling match it's kind of hard to do, but frustrate her. That's going to be her goal. And stuff like that. Dropping her across the top rope. As you can see, Ami is physically and emotionally just fatigued right now. Maybe she's not as recovered as she thought she was. She's trying to get herself psyched up a little bit. That's Astarte makes her back into the ring, and she knocks her right back out. As if to say, is that all you got, woman? And again, I'm going to give Ami this. She is taking this match by the horns. That's what you have to do. And Astarte, for the first time in a long time, a little confused. Oh! Goes all the way over. It's a tope con hilo onto Astarte. Oh, went for a ace crusher. Did not quite hit it. That ace crusher she calls the Mercury Stunner. That would have ended this match, I do believe. Or would have ended the average wrestler. But as you and I both know, Astarte is no average wrestler. And the match continues on. Astarte now has got her up. Oh, and throws her throat first right across the ring. And Astarte gonna do it again, it would appear. Throws her clear across the ring. She is having her way with Ami Mizuno. I've been thinking of that choke slam that she's made so famous over the years. Hope she's got her up. Oh, and a Samoan drop into a reverse Mexican surfboard. And Astarte now got her hand out. Could be thinking choke slam. What a maneuver that. Oh, here it is. Choke slam. Is she going to get her up? No. Reverse into a DDT by Ami Mizuno. And Ami now. Some dirty boxing. Putting those fists right into the breadbasket. Oh, and a snap vertical suplex by Ami right onto Astarte. Break to the eyes there, though. That'll stop the rally. And, nope, kip up. Oh, here it is. No one for the Mercury Stunner. Did not hit it. She's got her. Now, wait a second. Could this be? There it is. Mercury Stunner. Mercury Stunner, and this match could very well be over. Cover now, hook of the leg. Is it one? Is it two? No. You know, very rarely do you see a wrestler kicking out of the Mercury Stunner. Even if it is someone as evil as Astarte. Now, controls this matchup again, fans. And, oh, nope, tripped there by Ami. Went for a spinning wheel kick, but Astarte still somewhat discombobulated. Ami now trying to keep this rally going. Astarte now, and again, that springboard clubbing that she does. This woman is just vile. That's the only word I can think of to describe her. Just vile. Nope. Reversal there. Evenly matched this contest, but... Oh, she's got Ami. Oh, club there, and now went for a clothesline. Ducked under. And... Oh! Almost a modified suplex maneuver. This has been one brutal, one violent, and one dangerous matchup. A third time she went for a choke slam, but reversed out again by Ami Mizuno. Oh, but that clothesline will stop anybody. I'm now going to ram her head right into the ring canvas. This matchup has been brutal, folks. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, that's a choke slam. And she's got Ami up. Could she be thinking the Jihad driver? She's got her in perfect position for it. Oh, there it is. She's got her up. Oh, wait a minute. It could be either the Shiva's Edge or the Jihad driver. Either way, it's a bad landing from a short trip, and there it is, the Jihad driver. Well, wait a minute, what the hell? That's Abdala. The heck is going on here? She's got Ami up. What is she doing? Abdala. Making her way to the ring. She has got something in mind, folks. It's not going to be good. Vanquisher, what the hell is she talking about? She's got Ami. What in the hell? My, what is going on? My, she appears to have a Senshi bracelet on. Is this what she means by, oh my god? Ami's, it appears she's getting weaker. What in the, oh my god. Oh my, it would appear, oh, drops to the floor. Oh my, I think she just did drain the rest of her powers. What has happened to Ami? She's not getting up. Reappearing in a blinding flash of light. Well, Astarte's now back in, and these two ladies are exchanging blows in the middle of this ring. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a shocking ending. We are out of time, folks. We'll see you next week for the season finale of VWF Monday Nitro. It's going to be a shocker, folks. We hope to see you here. Good night. Let's get security out here.